to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Let us reach.
Father, you bless us with all good things. We are baptized in your goodness and cleansed by your holy waters. This symbol banishes the darkness and brings with it untold joy and the blessings of abundance. Always be our light, leading us to the dawn of a new day and a new eternity. Banish the darkness of night. Save us from the evils of our sins, holding us ever worthy to be clothed in light and kept safely home in your kingdom, which will last forever and ever. God our Father, you sent us your only Son to die for us, that we might live. You ask so little of us for so great a sacrifice. How can we repay you for all the good you have granted us? By taking your cross, by following your word, and living by the example of Christ, your Son, our Paschal sacrifice, may we never falter from the path we follow in his footsteps. Then, after a life of love and service in his name, may we find the peace and joy that can only be found in the embrace of your heavenly kingdom. Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. But I told you that although you have seen me, you do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me. Because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Father and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, as we are taping this evening prayer for you, it is the feast of St. Catherine of Siena. And on this feast, we recognize a great saint who had a great devotion to the Eucharist. I think that if the coronavirus had any positive effects on any of us, it might be that we are all much, much deeper in our devotion to the Eucharist, especially this time when it's so hard for people to receive communion, almost impossible. We have been practicing spiritual communion, but it's not the same. It's not the same. And soon, hopefully, one way or another, somehow, the church will figure out a way, as our world begins to open up, for us too to come back safely and to begin again the practice of our faith and the practice of receiving communion. I would like to use this time of reflection to read this part from Catherine of Siena, from her book on the Dialogue on Divine Providence. Catherine tells us, Eternal Trinity, you are a deep ocean in which the more I seek, the more I find, and the more I find, the more I seek. You satisfy my soul, yet leave it hungry. For in your depths, my satisfaction and satisfied soul desires you still more and yearns to see you, the light in your own light. I tasted, and in my mind's eye, with the aid of your light, I saw the abyss of yourself, eternal Trinity, and the beauty of your creation. Therefore, clothing myself in you, I saw myself as your image, filled with your power, eternal Father, and with the wisdom which is your Son. Your Holy Spirit gave me a will that I might love. You are the Creator, eternal Trinity, and I am your creature. In your light, I saw that once I was recreated by the blood of your Son. You were enthralled by the beauty of your own creation. O abyss, eternal Trinity, O Godhead, bottomless sea, what more could you give me than yourself? You are a fire ever burning, but not consumed, and you consume in your flame all my soul's self-love. You are a fire that warms all things. You illumine minds with your light, and in that light, you enable me to perceive and understand your wisdom and truth. In your light, I know you to be the supreme good, the good beyond every good, the beauty beyond all beauty, the wisdom beyond all wisdom. For you are wisdom itself. You are the food of angels. And in love, you give yourself to your people. Unprecedented times, anxiety and fear have become routine parts of our daily lives. There will be a time when fear will vanish, and we will be together again, raising our voices in song and in rejoicing. Though darkness falls now, a time will soon come for singing. Intercessions of Jesus Christ, his Son, now raised from the dead, and lift our hearts and intentions, united in prayer. Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For all your beloved faithful, may they hold the joy of Easter close to their hearts, especially during these difficult days of isolation and anxiety. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For all the sick, especially those affected by COVID-19, may they know healing from this virus and find health and safety from all pain and illness, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For healthcare workers, first responders, and all essential employees, may God protect them and keep them safe from all harm as they selflessly sacrifice to provide all people with necessity and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, Bishop Bambera, and all religious leaders, may they be granted wisdom and courage to make difficult decisions for the safety of their religious faithful, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our faithful, during this time of increased patience and yearning, that they may be comforted by God's love, we pray.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For our beloved deceased, especially those who have died from the coronavirus, may they find eternal reward and peace in heaven. May their families find comfort and solace in the face of sorrow and pain. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Placing our cares and prayers at the feet of our Heavenly Father, we pray in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Has given us bread from heaven,
containing in itself all delight.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we give you thanks for bringing us safely to this evening hour. May this lifting of our hands and hearts in prayer be a sacrifice pleasing to your eyes. We ask this in all things through our risen Lord Jesus Christ, whose death sets us free and who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Divine praises. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the consoler. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be your holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be your glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God, in his angels, and in his saints. May the heart of Jesus, in the most blessed sacrament, be praised, adored, and loved with grateful affection at every moment in all the tabernacles of the world, even unto the end of time.
Sleeping.